Hey everybody, it's Gameragi. We're back with a new LP. This one is Epic Mickey 2, The Power of Two. Heck yeah, man, I've been waiting for this game for so long, since my first LP was actually the original Epic Mickey game. So this is like a long time in the works here. Been waiting for it. And actually, other people were pretty excited about it too, so yeah, that's why I'm kind of jumping the gun on my usual rule of waiting a bit. This game just kind of came out. Alright, that'll play. That'll play in a little bit. Don't worry about it. Anyway, yeah. Let's do this thing. So yeah, usually I wait a little bit after a game comes out to LP it, but I thought I'd make an exception for this because it's such a prolific Mickey Disney adventure. Woo! Yeah! Okay, so yeah, I've already played the game, just so I familiarize myself. And as far as I know, there isn't New Game Plus, which is weird because the first game had it. And there's also not multiple files per hard drive, so I guess I could make a file on my other hard drive. It's just a pain in the butt. So I'm just gonna start a new game.
Let's do it!
So yeah, it just says it just resets quest progress and checkpoints. I don't know, I guess we'll see. Alright, here we go.
Not long ago, a rather brave but mischievous mouse discovered a world I had created for forgotten tombs. And so, Hortensia and Gus headed back to the castle to reach out to the one Toon who could truly help them in their time of need. Working tirelessly for many days and many nights, Gus constructed a device that would put the fate of Wasteland back into the hands of a certain brave mouse.
All right, here we are in Mickey's home. So yeah, they added voice acting, which is fantastic. It's such a great upgrade, holy smokes. And here's Gus on our television. How you doing, man?
The curious intruder once again entered my workshop with one goal in mind: to find and retrieve my magic brush.
Oh, good old Yen Sid. So yeah, this is where the original game started, where Mickey got his brush, or Yen Sid's brush, and spilled paint thinner all over Wasteland.
My sorcerer's hat from its fragile cage, but how?
So now we're gonna take his hat, just because it's what we like to do. Heck yeah, Fantasia! This is awesome, man. Oh. What I really like about this game is that they put a lot of stuff that I know. You know, like in the original game, they put a lot of like older cartoons that I wasn't too familiar with, but this one is like a lot of newer stuff, which is awesome. So anywho, who to mirror we go? We're just gonna leave them to their business, I guess.
Suddenly, the cosmos spread before him. A plane of imagination, fueled by brush, paint, and thinner.
Oh, yeah!
With the brush in hand, Mickey saw that the very stars were waiting to come alive.
Sweet.
They needed only paint to dance once more.
Well, there we go. So yeah, wow, look at this. Man. Just when you thought the Epic Mickey games couldn't have better art design. This place is beautiful, man. And it's cool because this is actually on Xbox. I don't know if you noticed. But yeah, they put it in HD, which is cool. I heard there were some problems with the Wii U version, though, with frame rate. I'm not sure if that's because it was 1080p or what, but yeah, not really sure about that. Anywho, I think you get if you paint everything in this first like starry area. I already missed something. I'm gonna go back and get it. But yeah, if you paint everything in here, I think you get a challenge. Basically, this game has a lot of its own achievements kind of thing called challenges. You don't really get anything from them, so it's pretty much just like achievements. I'm not entirely sure why they didn't just use achievements. But, yeah. It's probably because it's multi-platform, they just tried to make it easier on themselves or something. This is so awesome! Painting the heavens! Sweet. Wait, I didn't get the... Wait a minute. Wait, just a minute. Dude, how do I check my... Oh. Dude, it saves your challenges. Oh, man. Okay, well, that's cool. What else did it save? Didn't save my... Well, it didn't save my pins. Okay. Well, the only thing it saves are challenges. That's okay. And there's a Mickey in the stars. Oh, look at that. Cool.
Finding himself at home, Mickey should have felt safe.
I would feel safe, but there's a huge head on the wall.
He wondered if Thinner could help him find the truth behind his unease.
So yeah, this isn't actually my home, is it? Oh, look. Wow, that's cool. It's like sketches underneath it all. That is awesome. Look where we really are. Back in Yed Sid's little place, I guess. All these guys are filling up the water there. So I'm not really sure if these serve a purpose, but you can paint over these and they'll stop pouring water. I'm not sure if that really does anything. But we'll see. I'm gonna try to paint them all. Okay. I guess that's all of them. I don't know. Because before I thinned them all and nothing happened, so... Come on. Sorry, broke the telescope. Good sir, and Sid. Disney backwards, if you didn't know that. It's pretty cool. So yeah, I'm going to be taking this game a little bit slower than usual. Because it's not a very long game, actually. In fact, I think the first game might have been longer, which is kind of unfortunate, but this game definitely makes up for it in the boss fights are really good. They're really hard, actually. And the art design and just the design in general is really good in this game. Unfortunately, they didn't really change their platforming too much.
Armed with the magic brush, what would Mickey do? Would he paint the world or thin it to nothingness? The choice was his.
That's right. So, if you're unfamiliar with Epic Mickey, basically, what makes it unique is that you can choose the way you play. Either by making the world a better place through paint, or just... taking the easy road and making everybody's lives a pain in the neck by thinning everything out. So, I think for this playthrough I'm gonna go the good way, good path, like I did in the original game. I'm not sure if I'm gonna do a thinner playthrough after that, unless people actually want to see that. So, we'll see. So anyway, we can paint this in. Whoosh. And we get a chest! So, I'm not sure about this game, but the previous game, if you use thinner, you got a lot more e-tickets. And not so many pins, but you could use the e-tickets to buy pins, so... I don't know, it kind of evened itself out. Masterpiece pin! Sweet.
Wasteland is becoming inert again, and with all the damage from the quake.
Not only that, but the Mad Doctor is back!
He is? And then where's Oswald?
Right here.
No! You had me so worried!
Sorry, I didn't mean to, but
I've been talking to the doc. He came to warn us that we're being attacked by evil creatures. He said they're part blot, part animatronic, and all bad.
He is up to something. I just know it.
Come on, Hortensia. Doesn't everybody deserve a second chance?
How about we try to get to the bottom of this? Where is the Mad Doctor?
He's helping with repairs on Main Street, but the quakes really did a number on the projectors, so we'll have to use the train.
Well, if you really insist on talking to the Mad Doctor...
Hurry! Let's go before the whole castle falls down!
Oh dear. So yeah, you can, the whole power of two thing is that you can actually have someone play as Oswald. Unfortunately, I don't have a second person, so he's just gonna be controlled by the crazy and crazy rambling Mr. AI. Rambling bambling AI. How you doing, man?
Oswald, double jump to glide across that gap.
So yeah, we could throw Oswald up in the air and use his little helicopter ears. Get across gaps, which is pretty awesome, actually.
We have to go! Hurry up, you slowpokes!
Hey, I ain't no Pokemon.
Hortensia!
Do you think she made it? Come on, we need to go around and look for her.
Okay. If you saw, Oswald just took his,
I bet you two can get out of here by using that balcony.
He just took his foot off and kissed it. I think that's actually from the original... Like, he had a lucky rabbit's foot. That's why he's the lucky rabbit. He takes his foot off and kisses it. For good luck. It's kind of strange, you know. Alright, hey, Oswald. Wanna help me out there, buddy?
Mickey, go over to Oswald and lob him up so he can do a bit... Oh my! Well,
there he goes.
Convenient. Hop up there and let's get going.
So, yeah, like... random places, Oswald will have an idea to throw you up or you throw him up.
Like both gears need to be spun in order to open the door.
And, yeah, that's basically how you figure out how to do a lot of stuff in this game. He just has to have an inkling. I need to throw you. What's down there? Oh, you know what? I need to go down there. Excuse me, sir?
Look there, Oswald. The machine holding your remote has sunk into that thin... If we're ever to get your remote, we're going to have to get the machine working again. Maybe there's some tune around here that needs painting.
Like the one Gus's little picture is floating near?
Yeah.
I'll just use my arm to take care of this.
Go get it, man.
Here it is! Now you'll see what I can really do, Mickey.
Another one? Look!
What are we waiting for? Don't you want to find Hortensia?
Yes, I do, but I'm stuck in a cutscene. So, yeah, he has this little thing where he throws his arm. It's called Boom Armorang. It's pretty funny. Honestly, I wish I could play as Oswald. Like, if I could just switch to him whenever I want, that'd be sweet. But they don't have that, unfortunately. Oh, well. Oh, biggie.
A genetic pin. There's a pin trader in Mean Street North who loves trading these. Oh dear, poor Marcus was put on medical leave when he got stuck under the table. His cousin, Jamface, took over the projector duty in his absence.
Oh. Interesting. So yeah, that golden pin, they actually serve a purpose in this game. You can use them to buy other pins, trade them in for pins, or scrap metal, which is used for a lot of stuff later on. So.
Get on either side of the turnstile, grab onto the handle, and walk forward to start turning it. That should move the lift up to the ladder.
Sweet. These things control really weirdly. You just hold up, and then you go up. That's how that works.
If we're ever going to get out of here, you'll have to use your remote to get these machines working again. Try shocking the switch that's connected to the machine. And let's see if we can get it running. Look at that. If you follow the cable, you'll see that it's sending power to the next machine.
Yeah, I know how to do this.
Oh, right.
Oswald,
there you go.
You need to hit both electrodes on the machine at the same time.
I like how it's explaining how to play as him, even though no one's playing as him right now.
This won't do. The charge isn't going anywhere. You'll have to redirect the current to get this thing operating again.
I'm all over it.
Go for it. So yeah, he's got this little electric wheelie.
By diverting the electricity up to the door, you were able to open a path to the courtyard. And look, the platform's on that machine in the center of the room. They've lowered as well.
Heck yeah. So he can interact with all these machines and also with the Beetleworks, which are the evil robots. Or not so evil now that it seems the Mad Doctor's on our side.
Oh, I want to go over there.
Oh my god, that was really close.
I need all the tickets I can get, though.
Not sure how 100%-ish I'm gonna get in this playthrough, actually, because there's a lot to do. Like, a lot. We'll see, though.
What do we got?
Another pin!
Charge it.
This courtyard leads to the train station. If we could just... Great! The path's blocked!
Doop! It's all your fault, Oswald.
I wonder if I can get over there.
Spatters in the castle? They're not supposed to be here.
Oh my...
Wow, I did.
You'll have to deal with them. To make them friendly, fire paint at an enemy. Or thinner, to thin them out. You can also use your spin attack to knock them silly.
Silly. So, there has to be... I'm pretty sure I went down there the first time. Huh. I didn't know you could just cheat right past all that.
Once Oswald jumps in the air, he can glide...
Oh no, I missed him! Well, I guess we'll find out. So here's the spatters.
Both of you can...
We're gonna paint
the
them into
together.
good graces. Good grace. I need more paint, fellows. You fight each other and I'm gonna get some paint. Yeah, headbutt. There we go.
Hey, guards! This place won't last much longer. Let's use that rubble to make our way to the train station.
Man, Dark Beauty Castle takes so much abuse. Especially in the last game. I'm surprised it's still standing, to be quite honest.
Alrighty, so now we can use this rubble to get up.
Okay.
Look out!
Okay, second verse, quite not the same as the first. Wait a minute, whoa. Oh, there's a chest down there. Whoa, ho, ho, I almost missed it. Look at that. I would have missed three of the random standard pins, man. I trapped those spatters under this rubble. Now I feel bad. At least they're friendly.
Friendly smooshed spatters.
Okay, Oswald, let's do this. Oh, snap!
A bit of cloth, eh? We should take this to the haberdasher and see what he can do with it.
Haberdasher.
So yeah, you use cloth in this game to get costumes for Oswald and Mickey, which is pretty cool, actually. And they're cool costumes, like the Fantasia costume and stuff like that. It's awesome. I don't know why I'm painting these.
What is that creature? Is it a Blotworks? Oswald, try using your remote electricity to stun that monstrosity! Once it's distracted, jump on the button on its head and see if you can get the Blotling out of the cockpit.
Sweet. So yeah, this is a Blotworks. It's a mixture of a Blotling and a Beetleworks. Unfortunately, Oswald is messing around. Hey, zap that thing, would you? Would you kindly? Please? You gonna zap it? No, you're not gonna zap it. Okay, alright. I'll just have to take care of myself then.
Through that door is the train station. Let's go!
There, now he's on my side. Which is cool, because You were never able to have robots on your side in the first game. You could only defeat them by killing them, so... It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. Alright, let's get out of here.
There you are! Come on, we need to get out of here!
Hortensia, how did you get here?
Well... You're not the only one who has adventures.
Isn't she the best?
Oh, they're getting worse. Oh, wait, are those fireworks? Oswald, I thought I told you to get rid of them.
I did. I meant to, but I...
Just a minute, you two. If Oswald were to shock those fireworks, they'd ignite, correct? So, if we move them next to those rocks and lit them off, then just maybe...
Just maybe?
Mr. Goss, you are being a little bit too informative. Hortensia's voice actor sounds a lot like, Popeye's girlfriend, Olive Oil. Don't you think? That just high-pitched, squealy voice.
Don't worry about it.
Boosh!
I'd turn myself around if I could help you, I'd be glad.
Don't trust him.
I think our first order of business is to get the projectors working again. Last I heard, Jamface was in Mean Street North. He'll know what to do.
You boys go ahead. I'll wait here until the Oztown projector starts working. But you be careful. I just know that mad doctor is up to something. Good luck, honey bunny.
Oswald, do you really believe the mad doctor is good now?
I sure hope so, Mickey. I really do.
Gosh, Gus, I didn't think Mean Street would be this... broken.
Well, it's gotten worse since the main quake. All the aftershocks have caused the thinner to come up, and the buildings to crumble even more. Gremlin Jamface will be overseeing repairs on the north side of Mean Street, and the underground is the only way over there.
All right. Wow, the Mad Doctor is like stuck in singing mode now. It appears. But that's okay. It's really awesome. Okay, so here we are. We're in Mean Street again. It appears it's been broken in half. The other half's over there across a chasm. Yeah. This place is looking pretty bad. That's alright. I think I'm going to end it here, guys. It's already been pretty long. So, next time we'll try to talk to Mr. Gremlin Jamface and see if we can maybe get to Mean Street North, actually. That's where he is, I guess. So, yeah, see you guys next time.